Hello, I'm Kristen Bandy, your host of the Better Today, Healthier Tomorrow podcast at Arkansas Children's. I'm joined today by Dr. Laura Sisterhen. She's a pediatrician here at Arkansas Children's. Welcome.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
She is a medical director at our pediatric clinic, and she's going to talk to us today about the eclipse that is coming here in Arkansas on April 8th. It's actually coming across the nation, but specifically in Arkansas, we are right in the path of totality. So today we're going to talk about eye safety, how to keep your kids' eyes safe, and why that matters and why it's so important. Before we jump in, tell me a little bit about what you do here.
I'm a pediatrician at Arkansas Children's Hospital. I work in the general pediatric clinic and in the continuity clinic with residents who are learning how to be pediatricians. And we see children of all ages from 0 to 21 and take care of them and their illnesses, as well as talk to them about preventative guidance and anticipatory guidance to prevent injury and illness. So that's why I jumped on this when you invited me, because I love to talk about preventing injury.
And how long have you been here doing this?
I have been here 20 years.
Wow. Congratulations.
Thank you. I'll be celebrating that this year.
Awesome. Well, I can tell that you're very excited about the eclipse. I see you've got your shirt on. She is very prepared.
Yes. It does say I was at the eclipse, but
a little foreshadowing.
I did buy it ahead of time.
Well, I love the excitement because I'm super excited too. Tell me, what does your family have planned? Are you going to
My extended family members are coming into town from Texas and Louisiana, because in central Arkansas, we are in the path of totality. And I have in-laws on Petit Jean Mountain, and that is a prime place to watch the eclipse, where the totality is the longest at a little over 4 minutes. So I'll be on Petit Jean Mountain with my kids, my 16-year-old son and my daughter, who's in the first grade. And we have our eclipse glasses, and we're ready to go and enjoy the magnificent, spectacular, awesome view that we'll have.
A little bit envious of your Petit Jean Mountain trip, because that is going to be an amazing spot to watch. That's going to be so fun. So we all know, we've been told every time there's even a partial eclipse, don't look at it. But why is that so important? Why should we really, really not look at it, even if we're super tempted?
Yes, it is super tempting to look at it. Parents need to know to protect their children, because the partial eclipse is going to be dangerous for children to look at, and it causes injury to the eyes and can result in blindness. And it's surprising, but even just a little bit of time staring directly at the sun is damaging to the sensitive eye. The light directed onto the clear surface of the front of the eye, which is called the cornea, can burn the cornea, and that's called solar keratitis. The light directed onto the back of the eye, the inner surface of the back of the eye, causes damage called solar retinopathy. And that is very dangerous to the eyes and causes blindness and vision loss. Technically, the light, the visible light and the ultraviolet light and the infrared radiation triggers a complex series of chemical reactions in the cells of the rods and the cones in the retina, damages these cells and prevents them from being able to respond to the visual stimulus. It also causes thermal injury, which is heating up the cells, and it literally cooks the cells of the back of the eye and injures them. And it can happen very quickly.
You had me at cooks the eye. That one, you know, really tells me how dangerous it is. Is there any more or less danger for kids versus adults as far as how the eye will react to looking up?
Yes, children are more at risk of the injury to the eye. Their lenses are crystal clear, and their pupils are a little bit larger. And they're just excited, and their pupils are larger than ours, and that allows more light to get in, more light, more injury and damage to the eye.
You're probably more likely to look even longer than they would normally, because an adult will be like, oh, that's not good. I'm going to shut my eye, but then a kid might.
And children may not know the dangers. They need to be constantly supervised. And young men and children are at the greatest risk of having injury. We know this from past eclipses.
Yeah.
That even though the young men know the dangers, they still take a risk.
How quickly can damage happen if someone did decide to look up?
There is no time period that's safe to look directly at the sun. It can be instantaneous, especially when looking through magnifying glass, like such as binoculars or a telescope.
Camera lens.
That concentrates the light and causes even more damage, and it can be instantaneous. So there's no amount of time that's safe to look directly at the sun.
What about a cell phone? If you put your phone in front of your face and you're like, I'm going to get it sneaky through the cell phone, same
thing?
Yes,
very good question. Do not use the solar eclipse sunglasses with your camera. It's not safe to use the camera, the binoculars, the telescope. They all have to have special solar filtering lenses that protect your eyes. So very dangerous to use any of that equipment. You really need to know what you're doing.
What are some of the damages that you've seen after the fact, you know, once these eclipses have happened and someone's come into the clinic, what kind of damage can there be?
The damage is the sunburn to the cornea, that clear surface of the eye, and the damage to the retina, that lining on the back of the eye that creates the visual, the vision that we see. That damage can cause blindness, and the symptoms to watch out for, should you know that you've had an injury or look at the sun too long, is decreased color perception, gray vision, distortion of the vision, blindness in the center of your visual field, tearing, light sensitivity to bright light. You won't know the full effects of the injury until several hours later either. So that's important to know that the retina doesn't have any pain receptors on the back of the eye. Mm-hmm. So you don't feel the pain when the injury is happening, which is another reason that it makes it dangerous.
Right, because you don't know that you've messed up until much, much later. Mm-hmm. Too late to fix it at that point, I suppose. And how long can this type of damage last?
The damage can last, it depends on the severity, but it can be temporary. And that means it may last months to recover, or permanent. It can be permanent.
This could be a thing that your child deals with for the rest of their life. Mm-hmm. And that's why it's so important to let them know the parameters with which to operate under when the eclipse is coming through. As a parent of, you said, a first grader, so I'm assuming 7, 8 years old, how can we ensure our kids are safe that day? Do you have any tips for, I mean, especially with the young ones?
Sure.
It's kind of harder to handle a 2-year-old versus a 7, 8-year-old. Mm-hmm. So what are your tips for dealing
with
this?
I have a lot of tips. So one, if they're old enough to understand, is talking to them ahead of time. So informing them about the dangers and being prepared with the solar eclipse special lenses. They're not the same as sunglasses, so you can't use sunglasses. You can't even double up on your sunglasses. You really need the special lenses that have been certified. And when I purchased my solar eclipse viewing glasses, I went to the internet and checked out, there's the American Astronomical Society. They have a list free to the public of all of the companies that they have deemed to be to comply with the International Standard Organization that says these lenses do what they're supposed to do. They've been sent to the lab that is accredited to test these lenses that block the visible light and the UV and infrared light that damages the eye. So purchasing your glasses from one of the certified companies, and when you get the glasses, inspecting them very good. So we'll inspect the glasses and make sure there's no scratch or damage to the lenses, and throw those away. If there's any damage or scratch to the lens, they won't work and protect your eyes. So don't use those. We'll also be prepared not only to protect the eyes, but the skin as well, because the partial eclipse may last 3 hours and you might be out in the sun for a long period of time. So
protecting, I wouldn't have thought of.
With hats. So we'll bring hats and sunscreen. So that's something else to think about. And another way, there are two other safe ways to appreciate the eclipse. And one is projection, where you and your kids can make an art craft and build a projector with aluminum foil, with scissors, tape, a box, and a white piece of paper. So very simple things you may have laying around the house and make a projector, because that way you're looking with your back to the sun. The sun will filter through a pinhole in the aluminum foil or anything that has tiny holes. So a colander may work.
We loved using our colander.
Or your overlapping hands.
Oh, interesting.
Or a woven hat. So anything where the sun can filter through those holes onto the ground or a white sheet of paper, and looking at it that way, because when the sun goes through the pinhole with a white sheet of paper about a meter behind the hole, that will project hundreds of little pictures mm-hmm. of the partial eclipse. So that's a safe way to look at the eclipse. And then another way is just to view it live stream on NASA.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then you can look at it, right?
Yes.
Because they have special lenses.
I don't want to completely scare families, because the children should participate in the eclipse. It's an awesome event that where it illustrates basic principles of math and science and physics, and it's a wonderful way to experience awe. And children need that feeling of awe about nature. It is a feeling that gives you happiness, a feeling of wellness. We come together as a community mm-hmm. where we feel a bond with each other. It's an experience of something larger than ourselves and beyond human scale. And it's supposed to be, I've never seen a total eclipse, so I'm very excited, but it's supposed to be amazing. Once the sun is completely covered by the moon, it will get 10,000 times darker mm-hmm. and stars will dot the sky, and there will be beautiful colors along the horizon. So it's going to be something that children will never forget.
Yes. And it is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, which is why mm-hmm. we want everyone to enjoy it mm-hmm. appropriately mm-hmm. so that they can remember it fondly rather than yes. remember the damage that yes. may or may not have happened mm-hmm. to their eyes. Mm-hmm. So I agree, and we are very, very excited about
yes.
it around
my house. The next one I don't think is until 2045.
Yeah, well, that's a long way away.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Well, mm-hmm. once in a lifetime opportunity. Mm-hmm. Get outside and enjoy it, but mm-hmm. let's do it safely. That's mm-hmm. hopefully what we will cover today. So we discussed symptoms and what to watch out for, but what happens when you do notice those symptoms? At that point, what do you do?
We would advise to remove the child from the environment where there's no further damage if they've looked at the sun, and monitor for the symptoms, but take them in to be examined with an eye professional, an eye doctor who can look at the eye and determine if there is injury, what the severity of the injury is, and work to develop a treatment plan with you. If you don't have access to an eye doctor, or you've never been to one before, then seek care from your pediatrician and we'll direct you to one.
Okay, so final thoughts on why parents should take the eclipse safety of the day seriously. What are your final thoughts?
Yes, take it seriously, because we know from past eclipses that injury does happen. It happens more likely to children. And the effect is quite serious, that blindness. So blindness, the loss of vision can affect a child's entire life. And it is something to consider and protect your children. That's our responsibility as parents and adults.
Enjoy it safely.
Mm-hmm.
Enjoy it, but do it safely. That's mm-hmm. the key points from the day. Okay, and my final question I ask everybody that comes on the podcast, what do you love about your job?
I love seeing children laugh and smile and just enjoy life and see them thriving. So I love to see children of all ages every day, and they make it meaningful.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. Thank you all for joining us. We hope that you enjoy the eclipse with your family and this once-in-a-lifetime opportunity that has come to Arkansas, and are safe while doing so. Have a great day.